Security Minister Jim Muhwezi made comments while appearing before Parliament's Human Rights Committee to respond to recommendations by annual human rights report of 2018 to 2020. The Uganda Human Rights Commission report highlighted use of safe houses by security forces to torture Ugandans among the top human rights abuses. But Muhwezi told the committee that the chapter of safe houses has been closed in Uganda.
I wanted to assure the committee that right now their record is clean. We do not have any safe houses. And if we had them, the safe houses are used for different reason, not for torture of people, but for keeping the people safe, or for operations of security nature.
Muhwezi noted that it's true government operated safe houses in security circles in Uganda, but they were not used for bad reasons like torture, but for security reasons.
Because when you respond, you said we don't have them, yet they appear in even the human rights report 2018, 2019, 2020, up to now. Even last time, Minister, you said that we don't have safe houses, but this is a problem in Uganda.
The issue, therefore, is abuse of safe houses. This has been the issue, that in sometime 2018, 2019, there were allegations of abuse of safe houses. But I can tell you that today, security agencies do not have safe houses.
He cemented his point that safe houses do exist all over the world, but they are used to keep some individuals who seek special protection from government, and sometimes they are used by security for training.
I have attempted to explain in many fora that there is nothing wrong with having safe houses. They are used all over the world, and they are indeed safe, as by the name. It is a place, a secure place, where you put someone. For example, you don't put in a hotel. I can give an example of late John Garang used to visit Uganda, and he would stay in a safe house.
Then committee members wondered and tasked the minister to explain why government found it necessary to phase out safe houses if they were good for security. The Kabwere County Member of Parliament, Stephen Mogole, asked the minister to explain whether the government abandoned safe houses after realizing that they were unsafe.
The then safe houses were unsafe houses. That is why, because of the cry of the public, you have just abandoned the issue of safe house.
No, we have not. What I'm saying, when they were raised was in 2018, 2019, 2020, okay? What I'm saying, one, the first response to the question I was explaining, I'm saying at the moment we happen not to have a safe house and there is no need. But if there was, we could have, and they would be safe. So the issue, then my number two, I was saying, the issue being raised by the human rights is that there are safe houses which are being used for torture, for wrong purposes. That was the issue.
This story was compiled by Fred Kajibi for the news.